Welcome to SSB online classes. Today I am going to give a topic of class 7, which is circular motion, and also we are going to see the acceleration, linear acceleration, centripetal acceleration, tangential acceleration and angular acceleration definitions and also derivation part in this video. Now first, before going to all the topics, I am introducing with the definition of uniform circular motion. Now what is uniform circular motion? If a particle traveling in a circular path the radius vector sweeps equal angular displacements in equal intervals of time, then we can say that the object is moving in a uniform circular motion. Now a particle, here I am considering particle is in circular motion, the object is of point size, that's why I am considering it as particle. A particle moving along a circular path whose radius vector sweeps equal angular displacements in equal intervals of time, we can say that the body is in uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion. Now when a body is in uniform circular motion, its linear speed will be constant. Its linear velocity, or we can also call it as speed. Its speed will be constant. Now the linear acceleration here will be zero. Its linear acceleration is zero. Now one more point related to this is, if a body is in uniform circular motion, we all say that the body is in equilibrium. No, it is not correct. If a body is in uniform circular motion, it is continuously changing its velocity. Though the magnitude of the velocity is constant, but every different instance its direction is varying. This change in direction is nothing but change in velocity. This is obtained with the help of the centripetal acceleration. So here the body is the net force acting on a body is equal to zero, then only we can say that the object is in equilibrium. If the net force is equal to zero, the acceleration should also be equal to zero. But here in this case, there is some acceleration, because of that acceleration, the particle is able to move in the circular path. So the particle in uniform circular motion is not in equilibrium. Since a centripetal acceleration is acting on the particle over the journey, the particle is not in equilibrium. So at every instance its velocity, its magnitude is same, but what is changing here? The direction is changing. Okay, at every time the direction is tangential to the path of the object. Next we are coming to the subtopic, that is non-uniform circular motion. A particle moving in circular motion or circular path. Whose radius vector sweeps means nothing but moves, sweeps unequal angular displacements. Here in this case we have seen equal angular displacement, but in this case we are going to see unequal angular displacements. In equal intervals of time, we can say that the body is in non-uniform circular motion. Now note points. Now as we already said that the speed is maintained constant here, but here in this case the speed and the angular speed are not maintained constant. Here in this case we don't have any linear acceleration. Here in this case we have linear acceleration, tangential acceleration, centripetal acceleration and angular acceleration here. Now we are going to derive the expression for linear acceleration in a body traveling in a non-uniform circular motion. Now this is my radius vector r bar. This is my initial position. Over a time period t, it traveled, it sweeps an angular displacement omega t. Theta is equals to omega t. First one is. Now this is my radius vector, as already said. It has two components. One is horizontal component, one is vertical component. So radius vector r bar is equals to r cos omega t I cap plus r sin omega t j cap. Now this is your formula for radius vector. Now here the particle is having linear acceleration. It has two components, tangential acceleration, centripetal acceleration. Now we the angular acceleration is, its direction is about the axis of rotation. Now we are going to see all the terms different in this derivation. Now this is our radius vector. Now if I want to find out the linear velocity, that is v bar is equals to d r bar by dt. Now if we do derivative of displacement with respect to time, we will get velocity. Like this here I am doing v bar is equals to linear velocity, v bar is equals to d r bar by dt. Now that is equals to, now here r bar means this one, we substitute this here and we will get the answer d by dt of r cos omega t I cap plus r sin omega t j cap. That is equals to r cos omega t I cap, if we do derivative it will be minus sin omega t into omega I cap plus r cos omega t into omega j cap. Now this is the formula for the velocity v. Now this is the linear expression for linear velocity. Now we are going to find the expression for linear acceleration. That is, a bar is equals to, how you get the linear acceleration? Definitely by doing the derivative for velocity. Linear velocity will get the linear acceleration. So dv bar by dt. Now we already know that v is equals to r omega. V is equals to r omega. So I will substitute that in this equation. V is equals to r omega. R bar cross omega bar. Since they are vectors, by d. Now this I can write it as d by dt of r bar. Now I am using here d by dt of uv formula, d by dx of uv formula I am using here. So first one derivative into second term plus second r bar into d omega by d. This is how the equation will transform. Now I'll substitute the r bar value here so that I'll get the next one. Now a bar is equals to, now here this one we can write it as d r bar by dt omega bar plus r bar d omega bar by dt. Now dr bar by dt means it is linear velocity, that is linear velocity, that is v bar in v bar cross omega bar plus r bar d omega bar by dt means rate of change of angular velocity, that is angular acceleration, it is alpha. Now here we have two components for this linear velocity, linear acceleration. So linear acceleration has two components. One is tangential acceleration, angular acceleration, and the other is centripetal acceleration.